Dr. P.D. Vaghela, the Chairman of Apex Council, NIPERS and Secretary, Department of Pharmaceuticals, Government of India. Shri Jayesh Ranjan, our Principal Secretary of Industry and Commerce, Government of Telangana. Shri Rajneesh Tingal, Joint Secretary, Department of Pharmaceuticals. Shri K. Satish Reddy, Chairman, Board of Governors, NIPER Hyderabad, and Chairman, Dr. Reddy Laboratories. Dr. Shashi Bala Singh, Director, NIPER Hyderabad. Esteemed members of Board of Governors, directors of NIPERS, distinguished guests, industry friends, faculty members, and my dear young graduates and students. Good afternoon to you all. I'm delighted and honored to be here today at the 8th convocation of NIPER Hyderabad. At the outset, my hearty congratulations to all young graduates for completing your studies in this prestigious institute with flying colors, which I'm sure made your parents and teachers very happy and proud. Today is an important day in your lives and marks the beginning of a new chapter. I wish you all a great future, and I encourage you to face life's challenges with courage and tread the path of innovation, hard work, steadfastness in your efforts, which will make you truly successful. I'm happy to note that NIPER Hyderabad is completing 13 years and has emerged as one of the most reputed institutions in the country. I would also like to congratulate NIPER Hyderabad for having secured 5th position in top 10 institutions of higher education in pharma category in India. This only reiterates the extraordinary work and commitment of the institute to education, research, and innovation in the field of pharmaceuticals. I'm sure that your time at this prestigious institute must have been enriching and extremely rewarding. As we all have witnessed in the current pandemic situation, the pharmaceutical, diagnostic, and healthcare sectors have emerged as a key sectors for the world. The situation has exposed the strengths as well as the weaknesses of these important sectors globally, which needs to be addressed and strengthened urgently. The situation also brought light the inherent strengths and resilience of the Indian pharmaceutical industry and the significant role it can play in current situation and also in any future healthcare situations. I strongly believe that bright pharmaceutical professionals like you will have a pivotal role to play in remaining and reshaping healthcare industry globally. Hyderabad and Telangana have played a vital and critical role in the Indian pharmaceutical revolution, which made the country not only self-sufficient in the medicine manufacturing, but also has made it the pharmacy of the world. Hyderabad today accounts for 40% of the total Indian bulk drugs and 50% of bulk drug exports to the world. We are known as the vaccine capital of the world, manufacturing more than 2 billion doses of vaccines every year and contributing one third of global vaccine output. We today have more than 800 life sciences companies, and this sector currently employs more than 120,000 pharmaceutical professionals like you. We are very proud that the pharmaceutical industry based out of Telangana has made significant contributions during the COVID-19 pandemic situation, such as manufacture of life-saving drugs including remdesivir, hydroxychloroquine, favipiravir, etc. We are also proud that the first indigenously developed vaccine undergoing clinical trials for COVID-19 is a result of the intense efforts of Bharat Biotech, a Hyderabad-based company. 3 other companies that are currently also engaged in various efforts to develop and manufacture COVID-19 vaccine are also from Hyderabad. One of the first RT-PCR kits approved by Indian Council for Medical Research was developed in India, and again, that was also from Hyderabad. And since then, number of other companies also have developed PCR kits, rapid test kits, viral transport mediums, reagents, tech-based diagnostic solutions, among others. I'm really proud of the fact that the city today serves more than 1,000 global innovators in their vision to develop innovative and affordable medicines for the world. This is indeed a matter of immense pride for Hyderabad, and it is a testimony to the city's growing research and development prowess and its unmatched scientific pool across different areas. We stand tall in the life sciences sector and are proud of our achievements. Not resting on our laurels, we have a vision, a strong commitment driven by our Honorable Chief Minister, Shri K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, to grow this industry from a $50 billion industry today to a $100 billion industry and adding more than 400,000 jobs this decade alone. Hyderabad already is home to the first and only successful life sciences cluster called Genome Valley, which is home to more than 200 life sciences companies. Cluster has a rich mix of global and Indian companies, including the likes of Novartis, GSK, Lonza, Chemo, Bharat Biotech, Biological E, etc. This cluster has also become the go-to destination for global life sciences companies wanting to establish presence in India. This is the reason why we have earmarked 50 acres of land for the establishment of new NIPA campus. I would request Secretary DOP Dr. Vaghela to consider expediting this establishment and building a world-class campus befitting the prestige of this institute. And sir, after we would have established this campus, I believe NIPA Hyderabad would not be in top five, but for sure it would be one among the top two institutions in the country. Similarly, we also had launched a medical devices park in Hyderabad during 2017. And since then, about 25 companies are in the process of establishing their units in the park, which already has a committed employment potential of about 4,000 life sciences and engineering professionals. All of these efforts of the government has already created significant opportunities for professionals like you in this wonderful city of ours. Another very ambitious initiative of the government is called as the Hyderabad Pharma City, which will be the world's largest pharma cluster, and we are confident it will further reinforce the leadership position of Hyderabad in the world stage. We are all aware of the Honorable Prime Minister's vision of Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliant India, and particularly the efforts taken to make India self-sufficient in pharmaceutical sector. I'm aware the Department of Pharmaceuticals, under the leadership of Sri Vaghela ji, has been working tirelessly for the past several months to ensure that we ramp up production of APIs and intermediaries in our country. I want to let you know that there cannot be a better place than Hyderabad towards contributing this vision. I strongly believe that India can compete with the likes of China only if we build clusters at scale so that we can achieve economies of scale as well. Hyderabad Pharma City will offer everything that it takes for the country to lead and ramp up production in a short period of time. We have spent years to ensure that the planning is done at a world-class standard, offering immense cost optimization benefits to the industry such that they can compete and they can remain competitive with their global counterparts. We need to put together a holistic roadmap to propel pharmaceutical industry to the next level. And please be assured, all of our support to the Department of Pharmaceuticals in your efforts to promote local manufacturing. This new city, the new pharma city, will help us create 170,000 new direct employment, new direct jobs, and 560,000 indirect jobs. While we are working diligently to create new job opportunities for professionals like you, I also want to encourage you to pursue entrepreneurial opportunities and become job creators. Today, Hyderabad is the only city in the country to house more than 20 incubation centers focused only on life sciences and health tech. More than 200 startups are working on innovative solutions in healthcare. Today, there is no dearth of capital for innovation and human resources. There is no better example of fantastic world-class entrepreneurship. You have to look no beyond this room and look at the chairman of Dr. Reddy Labs, Sri Satish Reddy, who is a shining example of how you can create a world-class company from India and from Hyderabad. As I said, we are making available adequate plug-and-play infrastructure to support all such ventures. We have created a dedicated institution called as the Telangana State Innovation Cell to offer mentorship, support, and help you in this journey. There cannot be a better time for you to pursue entrepreneurial opportunities. In fact, you may have heard a lot of entrepreneurs in life sciences space talking about how this industry will be the next IT sector for the next couple of decades to come. And I do believe that this is appropriate for this time. I want to quote the example of Dr. Anji Reddy Garu, whose entrepreneurial venture created one of the biggest pharmaceutical companies of India, Dr. Reddy's Lab. His passion for science and medicine has not only created a billion-dollar enterprise, but also more than 20,000 jobs and many more such companies. I must point out that all of these journeys, be it that of Hyderabad or that of Dr. Anji Reddy's, everything started from this very place we are all standing today, the campus of Indian Drugs and Pharmaceuticals Limited, IDPL. That is what Satish also was pointing out to me. He said, you know, he spent about 5 years of his life. I once again congratulate all the graduating students, a great success in your future endeavors. And on a lighter note, Madam Dr. Singh, I was just telling your chairman here that possibly if we really want to be numero uno in terms of pharmaceutical education in the country, sniper ke samne agar ek strategic bhi add kar dein, to naam ban jayega sniper. I think that will be a fitting tribute to all the young talent and youngsters in this room here. My best wishes to all, and I hope to see you all prosper and thrive in your endeavors and in your future. Thank you very much for this opportunity.